Hello, I'm John Russell. Today, let's explore one area of connection between grammar and pronunciation. This area of connection involves auxiliary verbs, verbs such as can, could, should, would, and so on. These words modify or change the meaning of a main verb. Consider this statement. I can speak English. I can speak English. The main verb is speak. The auxiliary verb is can. It suggests ability. Notice something about how I pronounce can. I can speak English. I can speak English. I changed the vowel sound in can. Instead of can, I said can. I can. I can speak English. Americans often do this change in everyday speech. This is the so-called weak form. Now, consider this statement. I can't speak English. I can't speak English. I can't speak English. Notice that in this sentence, I said the negative form of the auxiliary verb louder and in a high pitch. The vowel sound didn't change either. Now, compare the two. I can speak English. I can't speak English. I can speak English. I can't speak English. I can speak English. I can't speak English. This example teaches you a general idea about American English. Americans reduce or do not stress auxiliary verbs when they have a positive or affirmative meaning. Americans often stress auxiliary verbs in their negative forms. That is why the two statements sound different. Listen again. I can speak English. I can't speak English. I can't speak English. The next time you listen to Americans speak, pay careful attention to how they pronounce auxiliary verbs. With time and hard work, you too can pronounce these words much like Americans do. That's all for today. Keep up the good work.